Welcome, my grade 11s, to your English COVID classroom. Today we are going to discuss the invitation in today's lesson. I would like for us just to have a look at what an invitation constitutes and how to go about designing and writing your advert. Your invitation, sorry. An invitation is basically a written request. Okay, where you invite someone to attend a special occasion or event. The format and the wording of formal invitations follow a set formula, as you will see when we go and look at it. Then a touch of creativity can go a long way, especially when you think of the layout, your wording, maybe a figure of speech or play on words that you can use. It just puts that invitation in a different class. Also, nowadays people kind of put an invitation in a special container or box, or maybe sending it with roses or with a dove or whatever. We usually find that with your engagement and your wedding invitations as well, but also for christenings and so forth. People are getting very creative in that regard. It just makes that invitation very special. Your artistic and computer skills will also come into play, especially if you like playing on the computer. Then you know more or less how you can work with your format and your fonts and bold and curvy and so forth. However, when you do it in exam, you will not have a computer, but you will do it by hand then. You also have certain clear and precise information. The what is the type of party that's going to be held or event. When, the people need to know when they have to be there. The date and the time. Where, the venue or the place. And sometimes people nowadays even include GPS coordinates with that. Your dress or attire. Is it a very formal black and white tux event? Semi-formal, maybe just a dressy jacket and semi-formal pants. Smart casual, a jean with a jacket. Casual, very fancy dress, hobo party or whatever. Then the reply date, you will see they say RSVP. Respondez s'il vous plaît. That means in French, please reply or answer by this date to receive, your place there. You can't just show up at a wedding. The people need to know how many people are coming. They have to cater for them and reserve a seat for you. So it is very disrespectful not to reply to that. Then the contact details will also be included. Telephone, cell phone, fax and email. Also, please note, sometimes, especially on a wedding invitation, people include a bit of extra information. For example, children under 12 are not allowed because you need to pay full price for them, even though they don't eat that much and basically just take up a seat. So therefore, pay careful attention to what you are writing in your invitation for the people. Right, choose the layout and wording carefully, and that can differ from informal to formal invitations. Now, what is an informal invitation? It is a 16th birthday party, a sweet 16, a hobo party, a pamper party, or kitchen tea, or stork tea. Those are not usually very formal events. A formal event is a christening of a baby, graduation, engagement or wedding parties, birth revealing, where the gender of the baby is revealed with holding some or other formal event. Now, how do we go about this? If you choose your font when you type it, Calibri will be maybe for a 21st birthday invitation. Bertelscript, which is more curvy, you can use for a wedding invitation. Playbill for a Wild West party, and Britannic for a theatre invitation. You can see that the font will fit the type of invitation. So why am I showing you this? You're not going to do it on a computer, but when you plan your own font for your invitation, you can take note that it applies to the type of invitation. Then the layout and arrangement of your lettering or your pictures should work together to make the invitation attractive. Please note that you do not get marks for drawings or pictures or illustrations in your writing, but only for the layout and for your wording. Choose the paper you want to use carefully, especially if you're doing it for real. Okay, that can enhance your invitation, the color and the texture of the paper and so on. When choosing this topic in the exam, please take note of the following. You can draw a frame, okay? Then decide, is my invitation formal or informal? And then decide on the wording and the layout. Are you going to have it on the side or center it? How do you want to go about it? Bold lettering and so forth. But the most important thing is that all these relevant information, the what, the when, the where, all of this must be in your invitation. Okay. You do not get marks for illustrations, only for your wording and your format. Right, ladies and gentlemen, to show you two examples, I've typed out a formal one for you that says, Dominique and Ron request the pleasure of the company of Derek and Amonay at their engagement party to be held at 20 Morgenster Road, Freeway Park, Boksburg, on Saturday, 20 June 2020 at 1800 hours. The dress is semi-formal, RSVP by the 2nd of June 2020 to Amanda, 6 Kingfisher Road, Sunwood Park, Boksburg, and there's the telephone number, cell phone number, and email address of the person where you will reply and reserve your place. A very informal invitation, you can see, looks a bit different. You've got more carte blanche there on your wording, your layout. It's very informal. This is an invitation for a beach party. Dear Jody, you are invited to come and celebrate my 21st birthday party. Date 20 November 2020, time 12 o'clock till 2300 hours. The venue, Boksburg Wild Waters, 12 Adam Road, Bayers Park, Brock, Boksburg. The dress code, your swimming costume and sunblock. All the refreshments will be supplied. From Jack. Please phone me on this number to let me know if you are coming. So all the relevant information that you might need to know if you want to attend this party is included in this. Make sure before you write your final one, if you were to go there, would you know what it is, that what type of party, what you have to dress up like, the date, the time, and the place where it will be held, from who, and make sure that you let them know that you will be attending the party, since they are also going to cater for the refreshments, okay? Right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not giving you an assignment on this. I've given you three assignments to do today. You picked it up at school. There was a bit of a misunderstanding with the box system. They placed them on top of each other. It is not a problem if you didn't get all three. I will send it through to the RCL member, and then you can just do it on your WhatsApp and hand it in next Friday. Have a lovely week and take care of yourself. Thank you. Bye-bye.